We are live inside the Arizona Department of Health Services in downtown Phoenix. Any minute now, again, we should be getting those updated numbers. We told you all morning that you are now able to log online and check your zip code and see how many people in your community have tested positive for COVID-19. So this morning, we are now joined by Jessica Rigler. She is the assistant director here at the Arizona Department of Health Services. You know, we have looked at this map, Jessica, and there seems to be a lot of missing information on there. How do you want people to actually interpret these numbers?
You know, we really provided the map so that people could get a sense of what's going on across the state. However, we know that not everyone who wants to be tested has been tested yet, and so the map is just a partial picture of what's going on around Arizona.
So what do you want people to know when they look at that map and they look at that number, those numbers?
I think what one of the things that stands out to me is that we do have COVID cases all over the state. It's important for people to follow their general prevention steps, right? Don't go out in public if you don't need to. Make sure you're washing your hands frequently. Stay home when you're sick.
Can we talk a little bit more about the missing information? Number one, we've noticed that there are a lot of gray areas, especially in the tribal lands.
Yeah, tribes in Arizona are actually sovereign nations, and so we need to work with them to gain their approval before we publish data in their areas.
And then we also looked at the race breakdown. More than 60% of all people who tested positive, officials don't know their race. Why?
A lot of the data that's coming in is being reported directly from laboratories, and that data is not collected by the laboratory. So it's up to the county public health departments to do the follow-up interviews with individuals and collect that information.
So that's not a requirement when people get tested to ask them their race?
That's correct, yeah.
Okay, and another thing that I noticed that was missing is that the number of people who recovered. Why does the department not have the number of people who recovered? That would give us a better picture of our situation.
Yeah, we're working on putting together a good definition for what recovered means. Right now, we're not testing people, you know, sequentially to find out if they still have virus. And so we're going to look at other kinds of methods to identify whether someone's recovered, which could be comparing known cases to death certificates farther down the line to determine if people are recovered.
So you're working on it, but there's nothing in place right now. When can we expect you guys to have something ready to go to find out how many people have recovered?
I would expect within the next couple of weeks, we should be able to have a better estimation of recovered.
And speaking of timing, how come it took so long for the department to get this map up on the website?
One of the things we've really been focusing on is providing data a little bit at a time as we're able to verify its quality. And a bunch of our efforts are really driven towards protecting the healthcare system and ensuring that we're able to meet any kind of surge in cases and getting good prevention measures out. So data is very important to us. We've put it out a little bit at a time, but as soon as we're able to assess data quality and put it in a picture that's good for public distribution, we've been able to make it available.
All right, and last question. Yeah. You guys aren't necessarily analyzing the data. Why?
Yeah, you know, I think it's important to note we're not putting, you know, a ranking of top 10 zip codes or anything like that. And it's just because there's so much we don't know yet. You know, a lot of people who have this disease may be asymptomatic. They haven't been tested, so they're not going to be captured in those numbers. Providing a ranking or analysis gives an incomplete picture of what's really going on in the state.
Okay, well, thank you so much for taking the time to talk to us this morning. Again, we have more data, but you just heard the headline. It's really a lot to try to interpret, and the Department of Health telling us not to read too much into those numbers. They are going to change daily. They are going to go ahead and update those zip code numbers and all of the other information about the number of deaths daily at 9 a.m. So we are continuing to stay on this. Again, we were all in this together as we figure out how exactly the state is going to handle this and how we are all going to handle this at home. Back to you.
Maria, thank you. The newest numbers on coronavirus here in Arizona are now and just released here 5 minutes ago. We now have 3,702 cases. A week ago, we were at less than 2,500, and we know that 122 people have now died. That's up from 115 yesterday. Maricopa County has the largest number of cases with nearly 2,000. The good news, we do know that thousands of people have recovered from the virus, so that's the good part of that.